Καλησπέρα σας, καλοί φίλοι τηλεθεατές. Καλώς ορίσατε στην εκπομπή μας Faces, πρόσωπα. Ένα πρόσωπο που ίσως να είναι γνωστό σε εσάς, ήδη έχει κάνει κάποιες συνεντεύξεις. Για μένα είναι ένα ενδιαφέρον, πολύ ενδιαφέρον πρόσωπο. Έχει κάνει πάρα πολλά πράγματα, όμως έχει γράψει και ένα βιβλίο, το οποίο είναι καταπληκτικό, με ποίηματα τα οποία τα έγραψε στα αγγλικά, αλλά η καλή μου η συνεργάτης, η Δέσποινα Πικετή, η γνωστή συγγραφέας των κυπριακών σίριελς στο ΡΙΚ, Πέτρινο Ποτάμι, καθώς και Χάλκινα Χρόνια, το πήρε το βιβλίο και το μετάφρασε στα ελληνικά. Το έχουμε στα χέρια μας και στις δύο γλώσσες. Όμως, να καλωσορίσω τον Γιώργο, George Tardios, ο οποίος είναι εδώ μαζί μου απόψε και θα μας δώσει περισσότερες πληροφορίες. Good evening, George.
Good evening.
Welcome to Hellenic TV.
Ευχαριστώ.
Είσαι καλά?
Είμαι καλά.
Okay. Yeah. Nice to have you here tonight.
Ευχαριστώ.
Θέλεις να μιλήσουμε στα αγγλικά ή ελληνικά?
Ελληνικά. Μιλά μου ελληνικά,
ελληνικά
και όνειρα και... σου απαντήσω εγγλέζικα.
Δεν πειράζει. Εντάξει, οκ. Okay. Yeah. Λοιπόν, εμείς γνωριστήκαμε πριν λίγο καιρό. Mm-hmm. Κάναμε και μια συνέντευξη στο LGR mm-hmm. και μιλήσαμε για αυτό το βιβλίο. Mm-hmm. Όμως, να η ευκαιρία ξανά να τα ξαναπούμε, γιατί εκεί είπαμε λίγα πράγματα, διαβάσαμε κάποια ποίηματα, διάβασες κάποια ποίηματα, όμως τα ποίηματα είναι πολλά. Πες μου λίγα λόγια έτσι, καταρχήν για να μάθουν και οι τηλεθεατές μας, ποιος είσαι, ποιος είναι ο Γιώργος Ταρδίος, πού γεννήθηκε και πού μεγάλωσε.
Yeah. Γεννήθηκα στο Λονδίνο, αλλά πάντα νόθω πως είμαι Κυπρέος, mm-hmm. Ελληνοκυπρέος. Και που μητσής δηλαδή, που εκράτουν τη μάνα μου και έφτιανα έξω, που κράτουν το σέρνις έτσι πάνω, αθυμούμε, ελαούσαν της, «Why don't you go back to your own country, you bloody foreigner?»
Oh my God.
Και τούτα αθυμούμε τα, εν τα ξεχάνω.
It was that period of time when, you know, United Kingdom was in Cyprus. It was a Ioka period of time.
No, it was before Ioka.
Ah, before Ioka.
In fact, during Ioka, I used to get beaten up.
Oh my God.
Εδέρναμας, ξύλων βαρετών, συμμορίες στο Summers Town. Και σπάζαν και τις βιτρίνες τους τούτους που είχαν σε kebab houses, οι Κυπρέοι που είχαν σε kebab houses. Και που γιον των καιρών δεν τα θυμούμε, αθυμούμε τα δηλαδή, δεν τα ξεχάνω, πως ήθελα να γίνω Κυπρέος, ήθελα να είμαι Κυπρέος τελείως.
Είναι και οι δύο γονείς σου Κυπροί, both of your, both from where they come
from. Η μάνα μου είναι που του Μόρφου, ο κύρις μου που το Βαρώσει.
Α, πρόσφυγες και οι δύο, πρόσφυγες. Έχεις και άλλα αδέρφια? Do you have any more brothers, sisters?
No.
Ah, you are the only child. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Both your parents die, I suppose.
Ναι.
Yes. So, you grew up and you have in mind all these, you know, troubles and all this kind of thing. Mm-hmm. How about school days? I mean, πες μου για τα σχολικά σου χρόνια, τα παιδικά γίνα.
Yeah, well, το σχολείο που πήγα ήταν άγριο σχολείο.
My God.
Και ο deputy headmaster, ο γιος του ήταν στο στρατό στην Κύπρο, τον καιρόν της Ιόγκας.
Μάνα μου, γι' αυτό και...
Και παίξαν τον.
Ναι, ναι. Α, γι' αυτό και μισούσε τους...
Εμίσαν τους Κυπρέους και έθελε κάθε μέρα, ελάλε μου, bend over boy, you're late, αν ήμουν late, για μένα ήμουν late, έπρεπε να κάνω bend down, να με δέρει με το κανήν του.
Oh my God.
Ως που και που εδέρνα μας και πόξω από το σχολείο, εδώ κάνουμε και αστυνομία για να μας παίρνει στο σχολείο, να μας παίρνει έσω πάλι τη νύχτα.
Ναι, ναι, ναι.
είπα του deputy headmaster, Λαουτού, it's nothing to do with me. Your son being killed, I had nothing to do with it. Όχι, τούτος δεν ακούει τίποτε. Ήταν blinded, δηλαδή. Ελάλε μου, bend over boy, you want to grow, you stay here until you grow a long black beard like your compatriot Macarius. Ελάλε μου έτσι η λόγια. Και γέλουν δηλαδή, γιατί ήταν λίγο αστεία τώρα τα πράγματα. Αλλά μια ημέρα έδερνε με το κανήν του και πετάχτηκα πάνω του. Έδερα τον, πιένει νοσοκομείο τούτος. Ο headmaster είπε μου να έρθω κάτω στο γραφείο του. Λαλί μου, when my deputy comes back, you both can't be under the same roof. One of you has to go. Εγώ.
So, έφυγες εσύ, ναι. Και πήγες σε άλλο σχολείο.
Όχι. Ήμουν... Επλύνησκα παναθήρκια in cradles στο city.
How old were you when you left the school?
I think 15 χρονών.
Okay. All right. And then what's happened? I mean, how all these you know, ideas about the poems you wrote, they came? I mean, it was from your life and from stories that your mother was telling you, or what?
Ναι, ήταν που ιστορίες που μελάνε η μάνα μου για του Μόρφου και για την Κύπρο, γιατί που ήμουν 7 χρονών ήρθα στην Κύπρο, έπια στην Κύπρο.
Και έζησες εκεί?
Yeah.
How long?
Για 3 μήνες.
Ah, okay.
Με τη γιαγιά μου και με τη μάνα μου.
Yeah, so you met, people and...
Ναι.
Yes.
Και εκείνων καιρών οι Κυπραίοι ήταν αθώοι τέλεια.
Yeah.
Εκοιμούνταν πας στα δώματα τους.
This was after the you know, the Oka, during, you know, I mean...
Before the Oka.
Before the Oka, still,
before
yes.
the Oka.
Okay.
Ήμουν 7 χρονών.
Oh my God, everything was perfect then. You know, I mean, εκοιμούνταν πας στα δώματα, έξω, πόρτες ανοιχτές, they never closed their doors, the cars open, you know, their doors open, everything, you know what I mean, it was... paradise, yes.
Κι άλλες και μου πουλάει Κύπρος, τον καιρό. Και ήταν πιάστες, αν θυμούμε, και οκάδες που έπιανες βάρος, ήταν με την οκάν.
Ναι, μια οκάν.
Μια
οκάν πατάτες.
Yeah.
Μάλιστα. Okay, and then you came back to London afterwards.
Ναι.
And when did you start writing the poems, you know, I'm going to go in.
Να σου πω, που το σχολείο πάντα έγραφα και είχε youth employment officer στο σχολείο. Ένα μόνο πως έγραφα πείματα και πράγματα, ήθελα να γίνω δημοσιογράφος.
Okay.
Και επίαινα σχολείο τη νύχτα.
Ναι.
Ήταν δωρεά τούτα
για
να μάθω shorthand and typing. Και ήμουν ο μόνος άνθρωπος μέσα σε
γενέτσες.
Classroom, ούλο γενέτσες.
Αντρέπουμουν,
αλλά έπρεπε να το κάνω. Στο Youth Employment Officer, λαλί μου, είναι που θέλεις να κάνεις να μ' αφήσεις που το σχολείο, αλλά του θέλω, I would like to be a newspaper reporter. Και είχα το calculated μες στο νου μου πως είναι να αρκέψω μες την εφημερίδα την St. Pancras Chronicle που την αλλούσαν γιόνων καιρών. Σιγά σιγά, και αν ήμουν τυχερός, ήθελα να πάω στο Fleet Street. Λαλί μου, the only job I can find for you in my card, είχε δαμέ κάρτες. Λαλί μου, it's a clerk in an estate agent's office. Take it or leave it.
A clerk in the estate agent's
office. Where does the writing come in? Λαλί μου, θα γράφεις γράμματα. Έφια. Που τιόντων καιρών έφια.
Ναι. Δεν σε ενθουσίασε, ναι. Okay. And then... you become an actor as well. How? I mean, from all these ideas writing all this kind of thing, how you become an actor?
Because
you are
an actor as Αφρική,
well. Yeah.
Και όταν με μπήσω, είχα post-traumatic stress που την Αφρική, γιατί έκαναμε ένα ταξίδι που έκαμε 8,5, well, ήταν 2 χρόνια παρπατητή.
Πόσο χρόνο ήσουν όταν πήγες εκεί?
Νομίζω ήμουν 35 χρονών.
Και τα υπόλοιπα χρόνια, 2 χρόνια κάνετε το ταξίδι παρπατητή και μετά τα άλλα χρόνια?
8,5 χρόνια είμαστε στην Αφρική.
Ναι, ναι.
8,5 χρόνια. Σαν να ευολήσαμε μέσα στον πυλόν.
Γιατί έμεινετε τόσα πολλά όμως χρόνια?
Ξέρω,
δουλεύατε κιόλας ή...
No.
Όχι.
Έγραφα μόνο.
Α, έγραφες.
Έγραφα articles για το Southwest Magazine, Animal Magazine, για το Tanzania Tourist Corporation.
Money. Yes. Yeah, that's all right.
Yeah.
So that was, you know, the eight and a half years, you did some, you know, research, and then you ended up writing articles for newspapers.
Ακόμα ρωτήσαμε μας για να γράψουμε πράγματα για τη Τανζανία, αφού είμαστε στη Τανζανία. Είσαι στο Μορογόρο, ένα χωρκόν τούτο, Μορογόρο, που ρώτησε μας το Πανεπιστήμιο αν μπορούμε να βρούμε ένα λοησίταν πριν, που ήταν castle.
Ναι, ναι, ναι.
Ήταν divided up with walls.
Okay.
Κι είναι εδώ και η μάσα δεν μπορούσα να το ευρούσει. Ρωτήσαμε μας εμάς. Σιγά σιγά ήβραμε το και κάναμε το retrace on the modern map.
Okay. So that's a very interesting. And you're writing a book about this, eh? You wrote a book.
I've written a book.
And which you publish already?
No, it hasn't been published yet. I have an agent who is now...
So you're going to publish it soon?
Yes.
Okay.
I hope
lovely.
So.
When you have it ready, you come back and tell us about that book. But, okay, how many poems you have in this book? Κουμπωμένα σχήματα στα ελληνικά και patterned up shapes. Yeah. Why this title? I mean, why?
Well, patterned up shapes. Δουλεύκεν η μάνα μου ήταν ράφτενα σε εργοστάσια και ήταν Εβραίοι, Εβραίοι των Νοντζερών που είχα συντούντι τις δουλειές. Buttoned up shapes είναι όπως είναι οι Εγγλέζοι, όπως και τώρα οι Κυπραίοι στην Κύπρο νομίζουν πως είναι Ευρωπαϊκοί και θέλουν να είναι Ευρωπαϊκοί και ο Νοντζερών. Οι Κυπρέοι που ήταν εδώ θέλαν να γινούσουν Εγγλέζοι.
Ναι, ναι, ναι.
Για in order to pass.
Yeah, I know. To stay here.
It's ridiculous. And so, do the buttoned up shapes any Εγγλέζοι, because οι Εγγλέζοι για μένα ελάν τους η μάνα μου κοτσινόκολους. Είναι buttoned up shapes.
I know. So, okay, but... the poems are not all about you know, your life here. Most of the poems are based on stories in Cyprus from your village on this Morpho.
Yes.
Okay. Και είναι αληθινές ιστορίες, true stories, eh?
Oh yes. True stories.
Θέλεις να μας διαβάσεις κάποιο? You want to read one of the poems?
Okay.
You know, just to give us an example of a, you know, true story from, you know, Morpho, for example.
Okay. Τούτον είναι για τον Τζιρίν του Τζιρούμου.
Α, τον παππούς.
Yeah, ήταν παππούς μου.
Ναι.
Και ήταν, το όνομα του ήταν Γιώργος.
Αχα.
Που είναι...
Το δικό σου.
Το δικό μου το όνομα.
Πήρες το όνομα σου από τον παππού σου, τον Τζιρούμου.
Ναι.
Okay.
Yeah.
Και ήταν από τη Μόρφου αυτός.
Ήταν που του Βαρώση.
Α, από το Βαρώση, από τον πατέρα σου. Yeah. Μάλιστα. Okay.
Και ο πατέρας μου, πρέπει να σου πω, έφυγε που ήμουν 2 χρονών. Έφυγε που τη μάνα μου.
Εγκατέλειψε.
Η βρενάλη
γυναίκα. Ναι. Κλαίες.
Όχι, αφού ήμουν μητσής, 2 χρονών.
Δεν το πήρες είδηση.
No.
Πότε ανακάλυψες ότι έφυγε ο πατέρας σου? When did you find out?
Νομίζω που ήμουν 5 χρονών, γιατί έρχεται πίσω και δεν είναι τη μάνα μου για να πιάσει διαζύγιο.
Α, κατάλαβα, ναι.
Και η μάνα μου επίενε και βρίσκεν την κάθκαν του, δηλαδή.
Και λένε του, ελάνε της να τον αφήσει ήσυχο.
Ναι, yeah, και επίενε τις παραμάνες με στα βυζιά, αθυμούμε.
Oh my God, very good story.
So, ήμουν αιώνι που αναιώθηκα με violence.
I know what you mean, yes.
It was horrible.
It is, yes. And this one is about your παππού.
Ναι.
Okay.
Που έγινε και δάσκαλος.
What is called?
The schoolmaster.
Α, the schoolmaster. Α, ήταν schoolmaster?
Ναι.
Παππού σου. Μπράβο.
Έγινε και
στη Μόρφου.
Okay. Yeah, σιγά σιγά. Τον των καιρών που ήταν δύσκολο πράγμα. Δεν ήξερα, ήταν άλλος και έκαμε το. Αλλά έγινε και δάσκαλος και έκτισε το δικό του σχολείο.
Μπράβο.
Που τον πυλών και που τα άσερα.
Μάλιστα, κύριε.
Και ήταν μούχτιν το σχολείο, γιατί πίστευκε πως
education has to be free.
Yes.
That's good. Okay, let's listen to this. Okay. Interesting.
The schoolmaster, son the shepherd, Yorkos saw further than his barren village, his father's cobwebbed eyes. Education irrigated the land. In the schoolless village, no one could think of chalking themselves snail-like onto slate. Soon as they walked, they worked, made brittle by drought, at the mercy of what they knew. Once a year only, a river slipped through. Though his name marked him a cultivator, tiller of lands, he chose to seed sleeping minds, studying while friends slept, wanting to know more the more he knew. Kerosene-lit knowledge flickered into his eyes, fermenting in lamp musk, until moths drummed in his brain. Dawn, father found him among cold inklots, oil spent, hand carving the hip of lamp glass. Immersed in goats, the father was led by his son. Scholarships wrenched Yorkos free onto the camel caravan for Nicosia town. Mired in a rushing bazaar where nothing grew, donkey carts beating brass, liquid-backed water cellars. He nurtured a meager moustache to fill his face, the window vegetables in the blind widow's house. Cleaned and cooked for bed and board, became a schoolmaster. Winter, steaming with father's herds, moulded mud and straw into a one-room school, free for the poor. Others could pay in goat cheese, cracked olives, oaks of beans. No one came. With no sounds to support, it crumbled silently. Yorgos's bamboo cane parted fields, winnowed children from family crops, grazing beasts, parents' wrath. Deeply rooted, Yorkos argued, even fought. His prize, more minds in schools. The classroom ballooned with voice, Sumultal salted ideas like spores. Dam the yearly river flow, ripened village fields. People muttered, where the schoolmaster treads, the earth trembles. Yorgos picked, as expected, a vulnerable wife, swollen Eleni, village discard. Raped, she wept, pleaded protection. Without male strength, her child would spoil. Yorgos opened the door, planted his name on her son, seeded one of his own. Father tipped his hat to the schoolmaster's wife, felt the sinking weight of his heart. Both his sons grown, blown to foreign lands, Eleni reads him letters. His light is lost. Long study with parched lamps was to blame. Books and beasts lie fallow. Sleeps in sun he cannot see, awoken by leaves of air against his cheek. Eleni, Elenimu, is there a guest? No, my husband, just me. She dumps him down in his straw seat. He knows true knowledge can strike you blind. Men cross his door in sheaves. Eleni, no one, my husband, just me.
Πολύ, πολύ συγκινητικό ποίημα, το οποίο διάβαζα και εγώ ταυτόχρονα στα ελληνικά εδώ. Πόσα ποίηματα είναι, Γιώργο, σε αυτό το βιβλίο?
Νομίζω εσύ, αλλά πως
24.
Ναι.
Και τα ποίηματα αυτά, όπως έχω πει και στην αρχή, έχουν μεταφραστεί στα ελληνικά από τη Δέσποινα Πρικετή.
Ναι.
Και αυτό το βιβλίο περιέχει και ελληνικά και αγγλικά ποίηματα. Ναι. Τα ίδια ποίηματα, ελληνικά και αγγλικά. Πριν προχωρήσουμε, σε ρώτησα μια ερώτηση προηγουμένως και δεν μου την απάντησες ολόκληρη ερώτηση. Πώς έγινες ηθοποιός, πώς μπλέκτηκες και μπήκες σε αυτό το χώρο του θεάτρου του...
Που ήρθαμε πίσω από την Αφρική, είχα post-traumatic stress και σιγά σιγά έπια στο City Literary Institute,
okay,
που κάνουν part-time drama course, νομίζω over 2 years.
Yeah.
Και έπρεπε να πάω την νύχτα πριν να ανοίξουσι, γιατί έπρεπε να κοιμηθούμε για μέ, γιατί ήταν
πολύ.
Ήταν πολύ και ήταν oversubscribed. The course was oversubscribed.
Okay.
So we had to sleep in a cardboard box.
So you can find a space in
yes,
the morning.
Yes, so that when I, in the morning, when the door opened, I was ahead of the queue.
Ναι, ναι.
So I could get onto the thing.
That was a course, I mean, free or you had to pay?
No, we had to pay.
You had to pay.
Yeah, but it's limited the amount of money.
Uh-huh.
And I remember with post-traumatic stress, when they gave exercises to the students, the teachers gave exercises, one of the exercises was to tell a story that we had never told anybody ever before to the rest of the class.
Yeah.
And people, oh, I remember this girl, she was talking about how she used to be in a mental institution. She thought she could fly and she used to try and jump from the balconies and things outside. Yeah. And they used to keep her back. And she said, but now I'm okay, now I'm okay. And she was fumbling with her hands and I thought, oh my God, you're not okay. And then Tom, who was this old chap, who was the oldest student there, he started talking about his life and what happened to him. And we used to hate Tom because he was very mean with his money. Uh-huh. If we used to go to the pub after the course, he never used to buy anybody a drink. He used to
just on his own.
Him.
Yes.
Yeah. So he started telling the story how when he was small, his mother left his father, and he said, and she took his younger brother with her.
Okay.
And she said to him, Tom, I'm going to leave. I'm taking your younger brother. But if ever you have problems, you can always come and find me. This is my address.
Yeah.
She gave him her address.
Oh, my God. And how old he was when his mother lived?
I think he was very young. He must have been about 10 or
so
something.
So he stayed with his father?
He stayed with his father.
Ah, yeah.
And he said, and I stayed with my father. My father drunk. Yeah, but he was all right. He was very nice. I liked him. And he drunk a bit, but okay. What can you do?
Μάλιστα, ναι. And you have to tell a story.
Yeah. Yeah, but slowly, Tom telling this story, he said, one day I had enough of my father because he drank too much.
Yes.
And I left, packed my little suitcase, went to find my mother. I knocked on the door, she opened the door, and she said, Tom, what are you doing here? And he said, well,
You told me
to come and find you. Yeah. She said no. She slammed the door in his face. God. That was it. Yeah. And suddenly I could feel these tickles in my stomach coming up slowly. And I was feeling for Tom. I felt sorry for him.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I hadn't felt these feelings with post-traumatic stress. It makes you dead. You become numb.
Yeah.
You don't have feelings for anybody anymore. And suddenly I was feeling for Tom, and I thought, thank God, it's good. I've got my feelings back again.
Yeah. That's good. That's good. So this course helped you to find your feelings which you thought you lost. I mean, that's good. So how this, connection came up, I mean, with, Despina. Did you know Despina publishers
introduced you to her? She was recommended to me by Stavros Karayannis, who's from the European University of Cyprus.
Okay.
He's a lecturer there.
All right.
And he said to me, Despina is a translator, but she keeps the essence of what she does.
Uh-huh.
He said, there's another translator, I can't mention his name, who, he said, he loses the essence of the poems when he translates. He translates and it's good enough, but he loses the essence.
Yes.
Despina, for some reason, keeps it.
Keeps it. Yeah, you know Despina, her father, I think, is from Morpho. Do you know that?
I knew that somebody was from Morpho because I knew that she was there as a young child when the Turks invaded.
Yeah, yeah, she was only 3 years old when the invasion happened, and her father is from Morpho, and her mother is from my own village. Yes, I know her mother. She's my relative, actually. Her mother, we were cousins. So we have a good relationship. That's why, when I went to Cyprus and meet her, I haven't seen her before. That was the first time I met her.
Oh.
And I thought, because I knew she was a good writer, and we talked about her play, and she says to me, yes, I will I had already translated on my place, I will send it to you. So she sent it to me and I liked it. Betaluda, Butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, and I'm gonna produce it and direct it, and it's going to be on stage in June.
Mm-hmm.
So you do your best and go to Cyprus, but come back and see the performance.
Yes, if I can.
Okay, would you like to read another one
from
us? And we close with that one. Find a good one. And so we can...
Well, this is...
Yes.
After the Lemons
was...
I remember reading Lawrence Durrell's Bitter Lemons.
Okay.
Ikra Lemonia. About Cyprus at the time when he was there.
Yes.
And this is after the Lemons because 1969, it says here, when I went to Cyprus, I was looking for this person he writes about, Glido.
Uh-huh.
Glido, he says, was his best friend. They used to get drunk together. He used to go to Glidos's tavern and get drunk.
Okay.
So I thought, I've got to find Glido.
Yeah.
But, well, and this is the poem about
Glido
traveling to Kyrenia.
Uh-huh.
And trying to find Glido. After the lemons, at noon, Kyrenia's crescent harbour encloses like a crab, a simmering blue soup of red-sailed kikes, shivering, a bloodshot sea. Feathers of heat lift, fracturing the muezzin's call, ripe figs dropping, ear-raising howl of the half-blind hound, mistakenly shot by his master, who slips over sloped cobbles, oozing sour wine, salt zivania, and bitter, bitter lemons. An ex-freedom fighter, 9 years after. Fried on uneven streets, we seek Glido's tavern and celebrated Glido, Darrell's bosom drinking friend, their moonlit bonds baptized by whiny promises, whispers on a breeze, weaving stars, sleepy seas, sticky breath of jasmine blooms. That was then. Glidos, there is no sign. British bars locked up. Creaking harbour, cocks crowing, sweat stealing our sight. Only the old fighter caught between cobbles dare stare in the sun's face. His stumbling fingers shape our way. Steep path, warehouse of stone, wood double entrance, the screech of sliding iron. A squinting simpleton peels the doors apart. You want? Behind steps fall into a black, bat-black tomb. Glido Tavern, nor here. We droop. He sees our faces crease like candle wax. Before? Yes, yes. You like, see, I show. We sink into the murk, hands tracing air, advance like leadermen over tripwire chairs. Who's there? A strange voice falls into our words. Beside you, light, feel along the wall. The seized switch, clicking pistol shots rebounded by the gloom crumbles in my hand, fixes me in cyclopean guilt. In the blind truce we wait as if nursing wounds. Breaking the dark, the simpleton lobs back shutters like grenades. Freed light fights its way in. You see? Dust mote spinning desperately. Flat stone coven, four straw-pleated chairs, a seated figure, lizard still, arms feelingly outstretched, slowly unscrews its head. Who are you, my friends? I am Glido. The simpleton nods. Welcome, welcome. I am sorry, I am blind, my friends. Dust freezes in midair. Our hearts weigh down our tongues. In peacetime, British soldiers, drunk, aggressive, stamped him blind. No reason. I have written to Darrell, my good friend. He will help me. Doctor's private, you see. Hunched over, drawn into a shell. Skull grasped as if avoiding blows, a sea of pain chokes out his thoughts. The simpleton smirks, fumbles copycat fingers around his turnip head like pincers, sign of innocence, betrayed. Cuckold's horns.
That Τα κέρατα του κερατά, λοιπόν, έτσι τελειώνει αυτό το ποίημα. Εγώ συστήνω στους καλούς φίλους τηλεθεατές να πάρουν το βιβλίο, να κάνουν ωραία ταξίδια. To travel back to these places. Mm-hmm. These stories, they take you, you know, in very interesting places.
Yeah, because it's to do with the past.
Yes.
It's not to do with the present Cyprus. It's to do with how Cyprus
those
used to be.
Good days.
Yeah.
Yes. When the doors were open, when the windows were open, when the people were sleeping on the you know, top of their houses.
Yeah. And I remember my cousin got married. We went to a wedding and they put the sheet out to show that there was blood on it.
Ah, yes. Ότι ήταν η Παρθένα, you know, she was a virgin. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Έτσι κάμνα συγκεκριμένα.
Έτσι κάμνα, ναι, yeah, yeah, yeah. Και αν δεν ήταν, έφευγε ο γάμπρος.
Yeah.
Ναι. Γιώργο, χάρηκα που ήσουν εδώ. I'm, you know, very happy that you are here tonight. And, you know, I recommend the book to everyone. Κουμπωμένα σχήματα, λοιπόν, στα ελληνικά. Patterned Up Shapes. George Tardios. Μετάφραση από την Δέσποινα Μπρικετή. Στα ελληνικά, ένα βιβλίο λοιπόν που πρέπει να το πάρετε και θα σας ταξιδέψει στο παρελθόν με αυτές τις ωραίες όμορφες ιστορίες. Έτσι, πολύ σύντομα, τι κάνεις προς το παρόν, το μέλλον, future plans, do you have any?
Έγραψα ποίηματα για άνεμους που την Αφρική.
And you want to publish a book about it?
Καρτερό, yeah. Μπορεί να τα κάνω publish.
That's good. I like to have a copy when you publish it. And, you know, you are welcome to come here and, you know, talk about it as well.
All right, good.
Lovely. Thank you very much. And I wish you all the best. You're going to go to Cyprus very soon.
Ναι, τον Ιούνιο.
And you're going to stay for quite a bit of time, yes?
Yeah, 6 μήνες.
Bravo. That's good, that's good. Okay, Γιώργο, thank you and wish you all the best with your future plans and all this. Okay?
Thank you very much.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
Ευχαριστούμε και εσάς, καλοί φίλοι τηλεθεατές που μας παρακολουθήσατε. Κάπου εδώ να ευχαριστήσω και το χορηγό μας, τον Δόκτωρα Βασίλη Μαύρου και τον Βαρόσι Lettings για την χορηγία τους. Ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ. Πολλές ευχές. Εγώ και εσείς θα είμαστε μαζί και πάλι την ερχόμενη Κυριακή με ένα άλλο πρόσωπο ή πρόσωπα. Μέχρι τότε, να προσέχετε τους εαυτούς σας. Καληνύχτα σας.